Ohio head coach Jeff Bowles in his second season with the Bobcats, former player for Ohio as well. Kind enough to join us now. What are we, 4 hours, coach, from tip-off?
Yeah, 3 hours and about 49 minutes to be exact.
3 hours and 49 minutes for Ohio, getting ready to take on Creighton. Ohio, of course, already taking down the defending national champion, Virginia Cavaliers. First off, coach, congratulations. You're playing with house money. I know you want to keep it going, but what an incredible win over UVA.
Yeah, thank you. Just really proud of our guys and their mindset coming in. You know, they believe they could win. And I told them after the game, the power of belief, the power of confidence, and the power of unity is special. And, you know, we've been underdogs for about, you know, three straight games now, MAC tournament included, and our guys just keep finding a way.
What were you guys, a 4 seed going into the tournament? In the MAC
tournament? Yeah, we were 5 seed. It was a little deceptive because, you know, we had two COVID pauses where we missed a bunch of games. So we finished 9-5. Toledo won the league at 14-4, so they had 4 losses. Akron and Kent had, like, 5 losses. Buffalo had 6, and we were 9-5, and we missed a lot of our games. So, you know, we thought going in we could win the tournament. We had the talent to do it, and, you know, we ended up leading 117 out of 120 minutes in all 3 games.
Oh, wow. Yeah, the COVID, you had 8 games canceled, I believe, 3 postponed, and then you had the longest pause was almost 3 weeks, right, in February?
Yeah, it was a crazy time. With 21 days, we played on February 2nd, and we had multiple positive tests throughout the course of a week. So we had different guys coming back different times, and we had 9 guys available on a Sunday before we played that week, 3 games in 5 days. So we didn't even do a real 5v5 practice. We threw a manager in there as the 10th guy. And then we played Tuesday against Akron without Jason Preston and Dwight Wilson. Beat them. Then we played Thursday against Eastern Michigan, won that game, and then we played Buffalo on Saturday and lost that game. And then we had another positive test that weekend, and our last 2 regular season games were canceled. So going into the MAC tournament, we'd only played 3 times in about 35 days.
That's incredible. Well, when you're shorthanded like that, does it ever cross your mind? I think you're around my age. You played at Ohio with Gary Trent. Did you ever jump in there yourself? In the 5-on-5?
If I want to build the confidence up my guys, I jump in there. But I think, you know, it was different. You know, I called Michigan's assistants. You know, they were on a 14-day pause, and theirs was different because they didn't have positive tests. So,
right.
You know, we did conditioning and individual workouts for the first couple of days, did some half-court stuff on the 3rd day, gave them off the 4th day just to recover. And then that 5th day, that Sunday, we tried to, you know, go 5v5 up and down with a manager in there. But it was definitely different. And I'll give our guys a ton of credit. They're resilient. You know, we preach, you know, E plus R equals O, event plus response equals outcome. And their response to everything was just awesome.
Yeah, it has been awesome to watch you guys do what you've done, taking down UVA. Dan Helley with the head coach of the Ohio Bobcats, Jeff Bowles, trying to get into the Sweet 16. They play Creighton coming up here in just a few hours. Coach, I have to ask you, it's well documented by now, but I have to admit, prior to the tournament, I was not familiar with Jason Preston's story, and it is absolutely fascinating to read about a guy who was a senior at Boone High School in Orlando who didn't play much and averaged 2 points a game and wanted to be wanted to do what we're doing. He wanted to be a sports journalist. He was blogging about the Pistons and went to UCF for summer school, then got spotted in an AAU tournament, and it totally changed his entire course of his life. Did you know what you were getting in Jason Preston when you stepped foot on that Ohio campus a couple years ago?
You know, I thought he had a chance to be really good. And when I came, it was after his freshman year. He averaged about 5.5 points a game. And you know, he was about 6'3", 170 when I got there, and he grew an inch that summer and gained about 20 pounds of muscle. And, like, his story is the American dream. Like, I tell people all the time, it's a movie. And if you really, you know, go back and listen to every detail, the decisions that he made to get to where he is, like, one decision that he made differently, like, if he didn't want to play in the AAU tournament, you know, with his buddies, this probably would have never happened. You know, it's like he forgot his shoes when he was on the way to the milk house in Orlando and had to go back and get them. You know, then his family wanted him to just stay enrolled at Central Florida, and he goes to prep school. Just so many decisions that happened along the way. And, you know, as good a player as he is, he's a better person than the adversity he's been through, losing his mom, and you know, where he's at today. Is just, you know, I could not be prouder of him.
Just an incredible story. Lost his mom his junior year of high school. Didn't really get along great with his high school coach, primarily because the high school coach didn't like his jump passes, which is what he does so well. They actually changed the rule at Ohio. This was before you were there, to allow jump passes when Jason Preston got there, because he just kind of had a knack for making things happen. And now he's a legitimate NBA prospect who is helping you guys try to get to the Sweet 16. Coach, how about a scouting report on Creighton tonight? When you're putting stuff up on the whiteboard, what are the three keys to the game for you?
Yeah, I think if you look at their offense, you know, very dynamic offense, and our offense and their offense and our team, they're almost mirror image. You know, five guys in double figures. They shoot the ball at a 37-38% clip. You know, 45% of their shots are threes. And they just have great balance, 18-11 assist-turnover ratio. So we really got to do a good job transition. They do a phenomenal job pushing the ball, and they have four shooters out there that can make threes. So we got to, you know, be cognizant of that. And, you know, one of our bread and butters all year has been paint touches and post touches. So we have to try to get the ball inside on offense. And you know, we know they're going to trap the ball screens with Jason, and we just got to take advantage of it.
I'm so curious about what's going on essentially inside that bubble for the tournament. I'm assuming you guys had a shoot around yesterday. What else did you do to keep these guys busy? Is it hard not to overschedule because you want to keep them, their minds active throughout the day, or do you guys just watch other games together? What are you doing?
Yeah, so, you know, I think Dan Gavin and his staff have done a phenomenal job of trying to, you know, number one, get to this weekend. And, you know, they had the one hiccup with VCU, but they've done a great job of kind of separating, isolating everybody and being careful. You know, it's not your normal, I guess, NCAA experience from a player standpoint. But our guys, they watch the games, and you know, we have our meeting room. They have a bunch of practice courts in the convention center where you do your shoot around and your practices. So they've done a good job and just, you know, trying to stay focused.
You played at Ohio. You guys went to the tournament back when that Gary Trent team, I believe, was 95-96. More stress, more pressure as a player or as a coach?
You know, I think as a player, you know, back then, you know, you didn't know what you didn't know. And, you know, today with the social media and the attention everyone's getting, you know, our guys have been a loose bunch and a fun, you know, loving bunch. They love each other. And, you know, before we played in the MAC tournament, not one guy had played in the MAC tournament up in Cleveland before. So they went into that tournament, you know, with you know, just a loose mentality. You know, before the championship game, they're in there listening to music, laughing, talking. And I was elated to hear that. And it was the same feel coming into this tournament. You know, you don't have the same hoopla with everyone walking around and the open practices with the fans. So when we get there, you know, there's maybe 1,500 people in the arena, a lot of Bobcats. And it was almost like another game for our guys.
That's awesome. I love, too, the story that I read about your group text that you have with all those guys that you played in that NCAA tournament with. Do they keep you grounded?
Oh, a special group. You know, a lot of successful people, and a couple of them are going to be here tonight. And, you know, there's no better feeling than being on a team, a championship team. You're bonded for life, and you always have a connection. You know, you're going to be in each other's weddings and reunions, and we have a text chain. Like, we're in the locker room yesterday, on the bus trip yesterday, cracking jokes. And like I said, there's no one safe, you know, me included. You know, we played at Indiana, and they triple-teamed Gary Trent and left me and Geno Ford wide open. I was 3-for-10, and Geno was 1-for-9. And one of my teammates after the game came up to me and said, "Hey, you going to sleep here tonight?" I said, "What are you talking about?" He's like, "That brick house you built at the top of the key with all those bricks you threw up." And but love those guys, and you know, appreciate everything they've done for me and their support.
Last question before we let you go. Dan Helley filling in for Rich Eisen with Jeff Bowles, the head coach at Ohio University, getting ready to take on Creighton here in just a couple of hours. So kind to join us. Very generous of you, Coach. I know you got a lot going on. You set this foundation last season with a trip to Dairy Queen. Is that right?
Yeah, we lost, I think, five games in a row, and they were all close games. And our guys, you could just tell they're deflated after the game. And as soon as we started pulling out, I remember there was a Dairy Queen on the way in, I told the bus driver to take a detour. We're going to Dairy Queen. And I went to the back of the bus and told the boys we're going to get some blizzards because ice cream makes everyone put a smile on their face. And just a lighthearted moment. You know, losing's tough. Winning's hard. And you have to enjoy the ups and downs and just something to put a smile on their face, and it worked.
That's awesome. Hey, Jeff, thank you so much for your time. We had Peter King, Ohio alum, on right before you. I know you've texted with him. He's definitely wishing you good luck as well.
Yeah, Peter was awesome. We had a great conversation the other night. And, you know, there's so many Bobcat alumni out there in the university, what this has meant for them. And hopefully we can keep it going.
It is a Cinderella story. He played at Ohio. He is now coaching Ohio, trying to get them into the Sweet 16. They play Creighton coming up in just a couple of hours. Jeff Bowles, thanks for joining us. Good luck, Coach.
All right, thanks, guys.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.